So I have a chassis here. It's a plate basically bent at a very small angle. I'm going to be mounting these DC motors. This is a very common type of DC motor. You get it everywhere. I've already attached a L clamp to these motors. They are also very common. You can find them off any hobby store. So let's get started. I've already drilled some holes over here on the plate. You can see them here. These two are for the caster wheel, and these four are for the motors.
I'm going to be mounting these motors onto the chassis with the help of some screws and bolts. So bear with me for some time.
Now you can see that one of the motors have been mounted onto the chassis. For screwing it, there could be some problems. You might need a crowbar like this, and you hold it here on the side and screw it on the other side. Similarly, I'm going to mount the other motor also. Now both the motors are mounted onto the plate. Now I'm going to attach the caster wheel. Now we have the caster wheel in place. I'm going to attach the wheels now. There we go. We have hardware full ready now. Now the remaining work is all soldering. We'll not be needing the entire length of this wire, so I'm going to be cutting out whatever we need. We'll just estimate how much we will need by, yeah, so we'll need around this much of this wire.
Now I'm going to be putting some solder onto the wires so that they don't come off into single strands. It's a multi-strand wire basically. So when I dip it into the flux and put some solder into it, it becomes a single strand. It gives a binding force to those wires. So now that the soldering of the wires are over, we can start soldering these wires to the mount, the motor is itself. First we'll solder the right motor. Just put the wire on the pad, let the solder to melt and hold it there for 2 seconds and it should stick. Now for the other motor, we'll do the same thing here also. I'm going to be using the L293D motor driver. I have a pre-built circuit for this one. It's a very simple board. It has the L293D IC itself and some external components such as 7805 voltage regulator, which you can see right now. And there are some pull-up resistance on the board for enabling the motors. We have slots to add the motors, motor 1 and motor 2. Now I'm going to be mounting this board onto the car with the use of duct tapes, I mean double-sided tapes. I do have mounting holes on the board, but I'm not going to be using screws to mount them right now for simplicity's sake. I do have a driller also, but I'm going to stick to the double-sided tape for now. It's pretty simple. You have to tear off some of the tape. And one side of the tape is adhesive by default and the other side is protected by coating. You can stick the adhesive side on the board and peel off the protective layer to expose the second adhesive side. Now when you put this on the car, be careful you don't press it too much so that the soldering joints do not touch the metallic plate. If they do, there might be some short circuit and your circuit may not be working as expected. Now the next thing is to add the motors to the circuit. I'll consider the left motors as motor 1 and right motor as motor 2. It's just a convention and you could follow anything. So I'll plug the RMC connector to the correct slot right now. And there we go. So my motor connections are over. The logic input for the L293D IC should be given over here. And over here, the EN1 and EN2 pins are internally pulled up. The logic input should be given to these two pins here, IN1, IN2, and here also IN3 and IN4. EN1 and EN2 are enable pins for both the motors. I've internally pulled them high to 5 volt, that is. So this is a 5 volt output which I'll be using to connect to the decoder. This is a RF receiver circuit board. It's pretty much has the circuit which I've displayed in my website. It has the decoder and it has a RF transmitter receiver. And then even here also I'm going to be attaching them using the double-sided tape. So this is the receiver now and this is the motor driver. So the ABCD pin which pins here, that is the D1 to D4 or A, B, C and D pins should be connected to the motor pins, motor EN1, EN2, EN3 and EN4. So that I'll be using the jumping with jumper wires here
You can see these are both side female jumper wires. I will plug one here and EN one here.
Similarly, I'll connect the remaining wires from the decoder to the motor driver.
So, then I will power the circuit. I have a 5 volt outer here. I'm going to plug it in here which matches the color code. So now this one is powered and connected to the RF transmitter and receiver and the motor driver. Pretty much your entire RC car is ready over here. You'll have to now connect a battery pack as I've got here one. And we'll be using these batteries. Now there's a connect all the batteries now. I'm going to put them somewhere over here probably. I'll then use another duct tape to stick them. Let me see if everything is working by here. Now you can see that the LED is gone up. So we are good to go now. Now the car is ready. Now let's get to the remote. So this is the remote control circuit that I have made. It's a very simple circuit, so I didn't waste my time when making it on the video. You can see that I've connected four switches to give the inputs, four inputs, D0 to D3 to the encoder. And then I have a 5 volt regulator over here, which is basically, it will take a 9 volt battery. This cap is for the 9 volt battery. And then it takes the input over here and regulates to 5 volt here and gives me 5 volt output in this wire. And then this internal circuitry will pull down one wire, either D0 or D1 or D2 or D3. When I press each of these buttons, this is D0, D1, D2, D3. So they will then send this data to this 4 bit value over here, which you can see is Berg strip. And now I'm going to connect the RF transmitter. So this is the RF transmitter circuit. Whatever circuit diagram which is provided at embojournal.com is made into the circuit PCB here. For simplicity, I'm using them, but you could always make it on a GP board like this one. I've already screwed on the spacers. I'm just going to put them here. Now I have the RF transmitter circuit over here. Here I have two loops from a zip tag. You can see that this is a very neat way of attaching a 9 volt battery to your circuit. Try and figure out how I have done this, but I'm not going to tell you right now. There are two loops here, so my 9 volt battery will go inside this one. So once this is in, you can see that it doesn't move. I can plug this one in. The cap is plugged in now. And you have to connect the power supply to this. Now the power LED is on, so it's working. Now I'm going to take a 4-bit jumper. This is a 4-bit jumper. You can use normal jumping also, but I had a 4-bit jumper with me, so I'm just going to use it. So once this is done, you can see that the remote is entirely ready now. we have the remote and we have the car. Now you can see both the circuits are turned on. This one is turned on and this one is also turned on. Now we'll check if it's working. Go somewhere else to test this.
Now let's check.
So, thanks for watching, good luck with your project, and visit embedjournal.com for more such tutorials. Thank you.